The Philippine Stock Exchange held a forum this morning tackling legislative reforms for the country's capital market. One of the key speakers, House Committee on Ways and Means Chairperson Joey Salceda, highlighting government's efforts to address concerns of the business sector. Among those reforms making headway, he says, are the Private-Public Partnership Code and the Capital Markets Efficiency Promotion Act. Salceda also underscores efforts to fix the military and uniform personnel pension system.
There are four, basically, now that we need to talk. The biggest one is the PPP code, which is ready for the signing of the president, and the ease of paying taxes, which is also for signing of the president. There are two initiatives initiated essentially by the speaker upon guidance of Secretary Dec Go, of the which are the Capital Market Efficiency Promotion Act and the Create More. The MUP pension can now be off balance sheet, off GAA. Biggest achievement of Speaker Maldes and our senior deputy majority leader Sandro, because this, in several meetings in the speaker's room, we negotiated with the MUP agencies. So it is case closed. Hard work that the president has put. I can tell you that every page of this presentation has the fingerprints of the president. We've been so guided so that we are working really close so that we are trying to avoid any veto of this measure.
The president and CEO of the PSE, Ramon Monzon, meanwhile revealed the PSE is finally going to launch its short selling program after years of planning.
It's set to launch short selling within the month. More specifically, we targeted on October 23, given that all regulatory approvals were received for this initiative. To prepare our market participants, the PSE has been conducting several webinars starting last month. Just some salient features of our short selling program. It will feature all PSE index stocks, mid-cap stocks, and dividend yield constituent companies, including ETFs. ETF will also be deemed an eligible security. An eligible security cannot exceed a short interest ratio of 10%.
For our numbers that matter this Wednesday, 7.2%. That's the bank lending growth in the Philippines amid the high interest rate environment. The central bank says the growth in August is lower than July's 7.7%. Data from the BSP also showed domestic liquidity in the country grew by 6.8% to 16.5 trillion in the same month, up from July's 5.7%. Time for some local corporate stories, starting with SM Investment Corporation, which is optimistic its portfolio investments will contribute more than 10% to its overall earnings in the medium term. This, as the firm says, its portfolio business is now delivering double-digit contribution collectively. The company has invested in Philippine Geothermal Production Company and in logistics companies like Airspeed and To-Go, which reported a turnaround profit last year. Meanwhile, PH One World Developers, the real estate arm of the Megawide Group, eyes earnings of 11 billion pesos from two projects. The said projects are the 337-unit Northscapes San Jose del Monte in Bulacan and its 986-unit Modern Lofts Ortigas Hills in Rizal. And finally, financial services company Sun Life Financial completes its acquisition of Dialogue Health Technologies. Headquartered in Montreal, Canada, Dialogue is the country's premier health and wellness virtual care platform. Dialogue will operate as a standalone entity of Sun Life Canada and will continue to provide services to all their customers and distribution partners. The Philippines and Lithuania agree on Tuesday to collaborate on areas of technology, cybersecurity, education, and people-to-people exchanges. During his presentation of credentials to President Marcos in Malacañang, Lithuanian Ambassador Ricardas Lepavičius said the two countries can share experiences in addressing mutual concerns despite their distance. He adds the two nations can work together on laser technology, since Lithuania is a pioneer in laser development and production. President Marcos, for his part, said technology brings the solution to many problems. The lender's annual report showed the Philippines at number 5 with commitments worth $2.3 billion. Manila joins other nations such as India, Turkey, Indonesia, and Ukraine in the list. The World Bank says these commitments are meant to support programs to strengthen the Philippines' financial sector stability, expand financial inclusion, and bolster sustainable financing for mitigating climate risks. Manila was 2 notches higher in the World Bank's top borrowers list from its 7th spot in 2022.